So in this render, we're getting a chrome ball and a plane. And this chrome ball is reflected by the surrounding environment, and we need to have the reflection in that ground also. But right now, the ground is a plane, is reflected in that chrome ball. So our easy fix is that we have to use a shader called AI Shadow Matte. Now here we have the shader AI Shadow Matte, and this is the shading group we have here. Select the object, right-click, and assign this material to the selection, and then you can see that the ground plane is gone, and you have a proper reflection from that ground into our chrome ball. And we have the shadow also in that ground, and the shadow is reflecting in that ball also. This is exactly what we need, but the black patch is creating a big problem in this case. And if you use this simple method, you're not going to kill this black patch. So what you have to do, you have to do a little trick. So right-click, go create nodes, and here type file. Right-click on this, go to create as projection. Once you do that, you'll get this kind of nodes, which is automatically connected for you. And in this projection, we have to click this planner and make it perspective. And image, we have to take the same image what we are using for your background plate. And the filter type has to be off. So in this projection, we have this link to camera. So we are in perspective shape 2. So go to link to camera node and make this none to perspective shape 2. Now we have two things, that AI shadow matte and a projection. I don't need AI matte shadow shading group, so I can select it and delete this. So once you delete this, you can see the grain shader. So if you have no shader assigned to your object, you'll get to see that it is turned into green. So that's totally fine, there's no problem in this. Now what I have to do, we have to combine both of them. So in this case, we have an option called AI Composite. So in this AI Composite, we can see we have A and B. So now what I have to do, we have to select this AI matte shadow or AI shadow matte, drag and drop to A, and this projection drag and drop to B. So right click, I have no connection because of I don't have any kind of shading group. So I cannot assign this thing to this surface. So for that, we need to have something different node that is called AI Ray Switch. Now in this shader, we have a SG node that is shading group. So we can see that we do have lots of option here, that is camera, shadow, so and so forth. Now, first thing is that this composite node is going to be in shadow. Diffuse reflection, specular reflection, diffuse transmission, specular transmission, and volume. And in your camera, you have to have this shadow matte. Drag and drop this to camera slot. And now select it, right click, and assign material to selection, and you can click this play to get the render. Now you can see that we have this black area is gone, so we don't have any kind of issue with this black area before we're having. But we have a simple problem in this case. You can see that the ground is very, very dark. But the reflection we are getting is very bright. It is not happening in the real world. So what we have to do, we have to select this AI composite, and you have this operation that is over. So we have to change this into matte. Once you do that, you can see that the reflection is not that bright than previous. So you have the shadow in the ground, you have the shadow in that Chrome also. But this is also a very important part of this workflow, because if we are going to use this matte shadow into B and this projection into A, so now you can see that you are not getting the shadow into your Chrome ball. So very, very important that this order you have to maintain, that your shadow is going to be in A and your projection should be go to B. Then only you get the shadow in the Chrome ball also. So this is the perfect way to use your advanced matte shadow technique inside Arnold.